Welcome to Level Up, where you get the score on video games. Kirby remains probably the most unchanged Nintendo series still going today. Mario made a successful, dramatic change to 3D, the same can be said for the Zelda series along with other gameplay changes over the years. Donkey Kong went from platforming to everything else, so on and so on. Arguments could probably be made for other Nintendo characters, but it always seems that Kirby is perfectly okay moving in 2D platforming levels and sucking up enemies as he's always done. Any changes seem temporarily, as with games like Kirby's Canvas Curse. As a matter of fact, he's even gone 3D, or more 2.5D, for a game, and even that was a temporary change. Today, I'm going to look at that game, Kirby 64, the Crystal Shards for the Nintendo 64. The change to 2.5D wasn't the only change made to Kirby in this game. He also had the ability to have two powers at once. Now, I don't mean that he could store two powers and keep one in reserve, like in Kirby and the Squeak Squad. I mean that he can combine two powers, making a new one. The seven base powers you get in this game are Burn, Stone, Ice, Needle, Bomb, Spark, and Cutter. This means that you can have 7 abilities combined with 7 abilities plus the original 7 on their own, making a total of 35 powers you can use in this game. Though I can't help but frown that Wheel was left out. The abilities have always been the main attraction in the Kirby games, and with 35 powers to play with, this game is not an exception to that. But the one thing I really like is randomly combining the two powers and see what I come up with. Sure, at this point I pretty much know what I'm going to get, but the first time I combined Burn and Bomb to make fireworks, or turned Kirby into a curling stone with ice and stone powers, I was more than pleasantly surprised. P.S. Curling rules, gold and silver medals for Canada! This becomes a big part of the fun, finding new abilities and learning how to use them properly in your current situation. Not only does Kirby get all these neat abilities, but he also has 4 friends to help him along the way. Though Waddle Dee just seems used as a plot device, Ribbon just collects the shards, and Adeline will only give you the occasional life for a tomato, the highlight of Kirby's partner is actually his arch-enemy, King Dedede. Some levels, Kirby will hop onto his back and go for a ride as he hops along and smashes everything in his way with his hammer of awesomeness. I had to mention this because some of the levels are worth playing over and over again just for these parts. As with Pokemon Stadium, the only other Nintendo 64 game I've reviewed, this game has a selection of minigames. Though this time there are only 3, they are still quite fun. There's one where you collect fruit falling from trees and ram your opponents to get them, another where you hop along a path, either 2 spaces or 1, depending where the obstacles are placed, and another where you try to remove the ground from below your adversary's feet. The last one is my personal favorite because of how chaotic it can get while still having a sense of strategy, but they're still all pretty good. And once again, like Pokemon Stadium, I can clearly recall days where me and my friends popped in this game just to play the minigames. Though it's better explained this time since the only way you can play 2-player is in the minigame mode. Except for all of this, Kirby 64 was pretty much par for the course for Kirby, besides the collection of the Crystal Shards, which don't offer much more to the game, even with the advanced ability of the Nintendo 64. Kirby would release one other game on a home console, a racing game by the name of Kirby's Air Ride. Right now, there are rumors of a Kirby game coming out to the Wii, but nothing is confirmed yet. For now, Kirby has moved back to his original home of the handheld systems and continued to pretty much stay the same. And we love him for it. Besides, as we've seen with Mario and Sonic, eventually they just come back to making the same anyways. So Kirby, don't ever change. Unless you change into a wheel or something like that. The bottom line is, if you like Kirby, then you should definitely check this game out. Mostly just for the ability to combine powers. I give Kirby 64 the Crystal Shards for the Nintendo 64 8 out of 10 levels. I'm Leo Melanson, and now you know the score.